This video will clarify the process of deploying to Google Cloud Storage using the power of GitHub Actions. This approach covers a wide variety of automated deployment scenarios, but is most commonly used for data like static website files or application configuration files. As we embark on setting up this automated workflow, we'll dissect the workflow code and core cloud resource provisioning. However, we can't ignore the other crucial component of identity and access management, which controls access to our cloud storage bucket. Now, let's dive into the Google Cloud Console and create a bucket for our deployment target. Bear in mind, these buckets require a globally unique name. The specific nature of your use case will most likely dictate the region and the storage class for your data, but for simplicity, we'll stick with the default values for now. Next up is a trip to Identity and Access Management to establish a service account which is tailored to the needs of this workflow. This service account will be used by GitHub Actions to connect with Google Cloud. We deliberately avoid any project-level permissions. The required permissions will be granted solely at the specific bucket level. While we're on this page, let's generate our service account key, which is essential for our GitHub Actions setup. We'll create this key in the JSON format and then promptly download it. Avoid sharing this key as it grants access to your Google Cloud project. Let's now move along to the creation of a Git repository. In this repository, we need to stash some GitHub action secrets for our service account. To start this operation, we create a secret for our email, taking its value from the service account page. The service account key is the golden ticket to access our cloud storage bucket programmatically. So let's add that next. Armed with the necessary cloud components, let's return to the realm of code. Here, we'll create a new repository and some example files. Of course, Google Cloud Storage objects can be used for a diverse assortment of formats, both text and binary. Now, let's initiate the GitHub workflow specification, which must be situated in a nested folder of this format. Our workflow can be called deploy.gcs. Our code is only a couple dozen lines long, but let's walk through it. We're running this workflow on every push to the main branch and using an Ubuntu runner to run a gsutil deployment. Now, note that we need to set up the gcloud CLI in order to enable this gsutil command. This is going to use the two secrets that we set up earlier for the service account email and the service account key. Sometimes the pattern that you'd like to use for deployment is going to be different. For example, we're clearing the entire bucket before copying files in here. The default behavior is to overwrite files that already exist, but you'll never have file deletions. So, based on your own use case, you may want to customize this logic. Let's proceed to the Git commands. Now, everything is almost ready to go. The only thing left is to set up the permission so that this can successfully execute. We'll do that as a last step by setting up our Google Cloud Storage bucket for access using the service account. In the Cloud Storage bucket, go into the Permissions tab. Here, we can grant access for our service account. There are a variety of roles that can work here, and you get descriptions when you hover over them. Since this bucket already exists and we just need some object-level permissions, storage object admin permissions for this bucket should be sufficient. With everything ready to go, let's run that commit push and then check on that workflow in the GitHub Actions interface. Okay, it looks like we just have a small typo. Our bucket name is actually GitHub Action GCS. Let's quickly fix that and push it again. While we're on it, let's improve the top command to cover the case in which no files are found in the bucket, in which case it will throw an error. Instead, we'll echo the error code and then continue along. That will only be the case if the bucket is completely empty, which would typically only happen the very first time you run these workflows. Now, let's have another go at the workflow run. With our workflow now running successfully, let's just check our bucket. The files all appear to be good and have appropriate file sizes. Feel free to check out this public repository where we have the YAML file. We'll also include this diagram file in case you'd like to extend, modify, or reuse it. We'll keep an eye on the comment section for any questions and want to thank you for watching. Please enjoy responsibly.